It's all about two bridges in Belize. One is the McCall River Bridge in Cayo, the biggest bridge in Belize. The next is the Mullins River Bridge on the Coastal Highway, which is the new freight access from Belize City for everything heading down south. You are going to learn a lot about bridge designs in Belize from M&M Engineering and see innovative construction techniques from its director, Roky Matos. You will see the building of a bridge start to finish by the men of Cisco Construction. These two companies are building the most modern bridges under contracts with the government of Belize. Projects funded in part by the Caribbean Development Bank. This television program and upcoming episodes are part of the Greatest Places on Earth TV series, produced by Steve O'Dell. So get ready, because you are going to learn a lot as we sit back and watch To Build a Bridge. Welcome to these very special episodes of the Greatest Places on Earth TV series, entitled To Build a Bridge. My name is Steve O'Dell, and I'll be your host. Its purpose is to document the construction of two very modern bridges being built here in Belize. With the need for new and more modern bridges being of the highest priority, there is no better way to demonstrate the ambition of these two construction companies than to give you the opportunity to learn firsthand of the processes necessary in building a modern bridge. The players in this unprecedented TV series include M&M Engineering, with the innovative bridge-building talent of its director, Roky Matos, and his team, as well as the undeniable machine and manpower of the Cisco Construction Company. The significance of these two bridges represented is equally important, being that the first will become the biggest bridge in Belize, and the second will open up a new north-south shipping route here in Belize. It's been only 30-some years since Belize became a country, and many of our bridges were built by the British when they occupied this country. These old bridges are being replaced by companies like M&M Engineering and Cisco Construction. And that is the reason for this show. Those traveling through the winding mountain roads of the Stand Creek District will have to cross no less than 5 one-lane bridges. These troublesome 100-year-old bridges were designed for trains to cross, and thus they stop traffic and limit the size of vehicles and cargo that can be transported down south. The future of transporting cargo from Belize City South is the new coastal highway, a straight shot from La Democracia to Dangriga. On this road, we will cover the construction of a new modern bridge, built and designed by M&M Engineering, spanning the Mullins River. So now, with this new coastal highway, there will be no more need to brave the winding mountain roads or one-lane bridges of the Hummingbird Highway. And incidentally, this road continues on, crossing over 8 more brand new bridges built by M&M, and will, in the near future, lead into Guatemala, expanding commerce for both countries, thanks to the men of M&M. The other project, when completed, will be the biggest bridge in Belize. Located in the twin towns of San Ignacio, Santa Elena in the Cayo District, this new modern bridge will span the McCall River and is a saving grace for an area being served by not one, but two ailing bridges, the Hawksworth Bridge, built in 1949, and the low-lying bridge, which is prone to flooding many times per year. This area needs new modern bridges, as do neighboring areas which are still being served by hand-cranked ferries. These old-timey ferries are fun for tourists, but too slow for Belizeans with places to go. And additionally, these highways lead to the western border with Guatemala, so vehicles will need to pass in great numbers. This new modern McCall River Bridge has the attention of the entire country, and was built through a partnership between Cisco Construction and M&M Engineering, financed by the Caribbean Development Bank. This new bridge is the kind of stuff that dreams are made of. In years to come, the Belizean people will talk about the days when men and machine worked together to build the modern bridges of Belize. So let's roll up our sleeves, because we're about to get our hands dirty to build a bridge.
To Build a Bridge will return after these messages. We now return to Build a Bridge.
It is a commonly known fact that Belize is in great need of modern bridges. In this young country, every day, cars and trucks still drive over one-lane converted railroad bridges that are over 100 years old. Why, in some places, hand-cranked ferries are still used, or simply just boats. There are even some places still where vehicles must drive through the river. These old ways are great for tourist photo ops, but Belize is changing, and these times call for growth. M&M Engineering and Cisco Construction Company are dedicated to changing the face of Belize for the better. And no need for a new modern bridge could be greater than the need for the McCall River Bridge, soon to connect the twin towns of Santa Elena and San Ignacio in the Cayo District. Separated by the McCall River, a river prone to flooding, this area is prone to flooding due to the huge area that drains into the McCall River Basin. Although this river's levels are monitored by hydroelectric dams in three locations, when the rainfall is excessive in the mountain areas, the excess water spills over the top of the dams, causing a serious rise in water levels downstream. These beloved towns are blessed by being one of the most desired destinations for tourists and residents countrywide, and yet disadvantaged by these outdated one-lane bridges. The main bridge where traffic leaves San Ignacio is the Hawksworth Bridge, a 75-year-old cable span bridge built by the British long before the independence of Belize. Repaired and patched over and over again, this bridge has served the twin towns faithfully for 3/4 of a century, but its service has reached its end. Large trucks and buses exceed the weight limitations, and quite frankly, one lane is not enough for the volume of vehicles now. Certainly not for a growing city. The other bridge is a one-lane wooden bridge called the Low-Lying Bridge, and although recently rebuilt, this bridge will be covered with floodwaters at least 4 times per year, forcing all traffic to share the Hawksworth Bridge. This is a major pain for everyone, including the poor old Hawksworth. The new bridge is 55 foot high and 510 foot long. It has 2 lanes and sidewalks and will be the biggest bridge in Belize. With this bridge, the area will be able to grow the way it deserves. It is no surprise that this bridge is the primary route to the western border with Guatemala. This giant of a bridge is a partnership between M&M Engineering and Cisco Construction, built on plans redesigned by Roque Matos, the director of M&M Engineering. This bridge is anchored by M&M pre-stressed concrete piles and is supported by M&M's pre-stressed concrete beams. The overall construction of the bridge will be done by the men of Cisco Construction Company under the leadership of engineer Philip Penner. And this is not the first time that M&M Engineering and Cisco Construction have worked together on a project of this importance. Take, for example, the Southern Highway Corridor System, or the Pan-American Highway, which runs from the Southern Highway near Punta Gorda to the Guatemalan border. This scenic highway, built by Cisco, winds through the enchanting land of the Mayas, with 8 new bridges crossing sparkling rivers and streams, all built by M&M Engineering. This highway has a dual purpose and will soon create a new border with Belize and Guatemala, forever influencing trade and tourism between the two countries. Here is where construction and art are combined, blending progress and nature, and is truly something that should be experienced by all. A bright future awaits Belize with the completion of these new bridges, thanks to M&M and Cisco.
To Build a Bridge will return after these messages. We now return to Build a Bridge.
What you are seeing is the very last bridge designed and fabricated in England, transported across the ocean on board a ship, and then erected here in Belize by none other than Cisco Construction Company. These bridges came at an incredible cost for the government of Belize, and it was this overspending of the people's money that gave birth to the idea of using a local company to design and build these bigger bridges here in Belize, in their entirety. And that's what M&M does. Now let's learn more. This story begins where this pre-stressed concrete is being made at mile 12 near Ladyville. They call this the pile factory. Here, men are shaping this metal to become part of the piles. Piles are posts that are driven into the earth to give a structure a more stable footing in often unstable construction sites. This wire, wrapped around 8 steel cables, are the superskeleton of these concrete posts known as piles. But you ain't seen nothing yet. First, these steel cables are stretched like giant guitar strings with this air-driven tool. You might want to step back, as these cables will be stretched equaling 30,000 pounds, and then encased in concrete, made strong in every way, inside and out. I think that's F sharp, cadet.
If this mold is ready to pour, it has 8 5/8 tendons in it. These are cables that have been tensioned about 30,000 pounds.
So, you with me so far? Next, we add concrete. Not just any concrete, made from special materials, obtaining a perfect pour, withstanding great pressure and spanning greater distances. Hundreds of bags combined with a certain kind of gravel and sand, then mixed just right, moving along a conveyor belt to a waiting concrete mixing truck. This is plasticizer, which reduces the need for water, makes the concrete more workable, and produces a more dense concrete. The process is really very scientific and not very commonly known, and that is another reason why M&M Engineering is so in demand here in Belize. Well, the men are standing by awaiting the pour. This is all about timing as well. This special concrete needs to be worked and finessed in a timely manner. As the mix comes down the chute, at a glance, even an untrained eye can see that this is no ordinary concrete. See what I mean? These men will work their way down this mold, smoothing out the super concrete. Wet for now, but when it's dry, these piles will stand the test of time, supporting bridges and structures for generations. And a specimen of this concrete is saved to prove the batch.
This is what we call a cube that is used for cube tests. In concrete production, you do both. You do either cube or cylinder test. On this side, we're using a cube test.
Well, the concrete is hardened. Let's see what we've done here. Figured into this design are cable loops so that these monsters can be jerked out of their molds by a giant construction crane. 60 feet long and able to withstand great pressure and huge weight, mainly because of those 8 steel cables stretched beyond comprehension, then encased in our super concrete mix. Built in a similar way are double T-slabs, I-beams, and these unusual pier supports that we will see later on in the segment. Now on a bridge construction site, the engineers are working with surveying equipment to pinpoint the exact spot that these piles will be used, working with a blueprint and mathematical formulas calculating the exact location where the weight of the bridge needs supported. Now meet the metal monster who will drive this concrete post deep into the earth, called a diesel hammer or pile driver. Either way, prepare to be humbled. The men are making final adjustments and fueling up this machine as the crane stands by to hoist it into position. This crew of men work together, taking measurements and strapping the pile to the business end of this diesel hammer or pile driver. As one end of this 60-foot-long pile is hoisted to the heavens, the other end of the pile dangles dangerously as the crane operator swings it closer to the position for its insertion. Men muscle the pile the last few inches as it is lowered into the hole and check to see that it is perfectly upright. Upon approval by the boss man, this diesel hammer is raised to drive this first pile. With the thundering stomp of a dinosaur, the pile driver begins to slam this concrete post with a force unimaginable. Again and again, the pile is driven into the earth as a man monitors its precise descent into the ground. It's really quite an operation on the grandest scale, how these men harness the mighty power of this machine to put in place a structure as impressive as a bridge. As the ground continues to tremble beneath our feet, across the river, men are cutting off the piles already driven to the correct lengths to support the bridge floor. M&M does all of this and more, and at a reasonable cost, and the money stays right here in Belize. These are the reasons behind the making of this television series. Now let's learn more about the men who build these bridges. Life for the crew building a bridge is challenging to say the least. These men commit themselves to living at the bridge site, 10 days of working, and then 4 days off, for a year at a time, sometimes longer. These men are bending and shaping steel rods, building forms, and placing the steel, mixing, pouring, and finishing cement, welding, earth moving, and so much more. But there is also time to unwind, cool off, eat a good meal, surf the web, or kick around a soccer ball, because soon you're back to work on this isolated work site. These men know that they have a future with M&M Engineering, so they give it their all. They are the able-bodied sons of Belize, full of spirit and fire. Over at the Cisco camp, their crew is dealing with their own problems. Building the biggest bridge in Belize is no small feat. Working in partnership with M&M Engineering, they are doing tough jobs in the scorching sun, pouring rain, in swift-moving water, or 55 feet in the air, or, as luck would have it, during a Category 5 hurricane. When Hurricane Earl hit, the McCall River rose 75 feet. One would think that all is lost, but these companies plan for these types of things and work like the devil to stay ahead of the storm. So when the sky is clear, the men of Cisco and M&M continue on, keeping to the schedule, to build a bridge.
To Build a Bridge will return after these messages. We now return to Build a Bridge.
How does it feel to be part of the construction of the biggest bridge in Belize?
It has been a great honor to be part of the construction of the biggest bridge in Belize. We have been constructing bridges for over 8 years, including bridges in Belize City, such as Chetumal Street Bridge, all the way to the south of Belize in Halakte. This McCall Bridge has been very challenging, but finishing it has been rewarding, and it proves to us that we are able to build any bridge that can be possibly built in Belize.
Give us some particulars about your design for the McCall River Bridge.
Well, originally the McCall Bridge was a steel girder bridge. When it was put out to tender, the contractors that bidded on the bridge came in way above budget. And so Cisco Construction, which was the winner of the tender, came to us along with the government of Belize and asked us for an alternative design so that they could build a bridge within budget. So we came up with a design for a pre-stressed concrete girder bridge, which saved the government of Belize about 30%. The advantage of this bridge is that we are building it locally, and therefore all the labor is local. But even more importantly is that the engineering is local. And so a company like M&M Engineering gains a lot of experience from doing an exercise like this. Being that the bridge is being built local, we also have the opportunity that we stimulate the economy, and then the foreign exchange stays at home. So it's plus, plus, plus to build a bridge in the system.
Was the McCall an easy site to drive piles and hang beams?
Well, of all the bridges I've worked on so far, every single bridge has its own sets of challenges. And the McCall site was definitely one of the masters of them all. First of all, the river is very wide, and there's a very deep ravine to get down to the riverbed. So it was very complicated for us to take big machinery to the bottom, such as big cranes, to dry piling, as well as to take these 60-ton beams to the bottom of the river to be able to hang the beams. Secondly, the river looks very tranquil, but on any given moment, the river can raise 5 or 6 feet or even 10 feet. You can lose equipment down there in that process. So it was also a very dangerous project in that sense. So it had some very challenging moments for us, but we overcame it all.
Which part of the beam process was the most complicated? Creating the beams, loading the beams, transporting the beams, or hanging the beams, and why?
The whole process was complicated because this is the first time that M&M Engineering was embarking in such big beams. These beams were almost 60 tons in weight, and they were 115 feet long. So from building them in our factory to moving them out of the yard to transporting them all the way to San Ignacio, going down a very deep ravine and then hanging them over 50 feet high in the sky was very complicated. But for me, the two most, I would say the three steps that were equally most complicated for us was one, getting them through the hills of Belize where we needed to have an additional crane by the Mount Hope area to pull the trucks up and down the hills because the truck by itself could not take the load. Secondly, going down the very, very, very steep ravine to the bottom of the bridge was also very complex. We had to have a big bulldozer helping the trucks so that they don't slide or going down. And then finally, the hanging of these extremely big beams required two crane operators with extremely good coordination so that one crane didn't pull over the other crane and the beam would fall or the crane would collapse.
Besides bridges, what other types of construction does M&M do?
M&M Engineering does warehouse buildings, office complex, commercial buildings, tilt-up wall buildings, seawalls, piers, and precast/pre-stressed tanks. We also make a whole host of products, which includes double T's, T-beams, septic tanks, pilings, and culverts.
Tell us about your new TV show, To Build a Bridge.
I'm very excited to have this show, To Build a Bridge TV show in Belize. I think the show will show the Belizean public a lot of, about the construction of building a bridge in Belize. Oftentimes, the construction of a bridge occurs far away from the eyes of the public and they're not able to see what really goes on in the construction of a bridge. With the show, we'll be able to showcase that to the Belizean public, and they will be able to learn a lot of about the capabilities of what we can do, what M&M Engineering can do in this country.
What's in the future for M&M Engineering?
We think the future of M&M Engineering in this country is to continue to build Belize. We are very excited and we have some new projects and new products online. We will definitely expand our product lines of what we are building and supplying to the contractors and the contracting market, as well as the homeowners, as well as some massive projects in the future, which we will definitely be a part of.
Here at the Pile Factory, men are making piles and beams, 5/8 steel cable wrapped with heavy coiled wire. And all 8 cables are pulled tight to 30,000 pounds, like giant guitar strings. And then encased in high-density concrete with special additives like plasticizer and the perfect mix of sand and gravel. And this is how you make pre-stressed concrete beams. And when this super concrete comes down the chute, the men get busy filling up the molds, spreading, settling, and smoothing the concrete around the tightly stretched cable and wire skeleton that is now inside the concrete. For one day, the concrete bakes in the hot Belize sun. Then men hook up cables and jerk it out of its mold with a gigantic crane. Your day has come, Mr. Bean. You will be hoisted on high, strapped to the hammer, and pounded into the ground. You will become what holds in place a gigantic bridge, you and 60 of your friends. And this is how it begins. Slam, 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 again and again. This is what they do at M&M. And now you are seeing the crew loading a beam onto a truck. They back up and under on one end and lift up and over with the crane in the rear. Brother, you don't know what heavy is. 60 tons to pull down the road, strapped down by 16 chains. My heart's pounding all the way. For 100 miles, we run with the police in the front and the police in the rear. But there's one hill the truck can't pull, so a crane waits to pull us up to the other side. When you're 130 foot long, you need lots of space to turn. So you'll have to run over a lot of curbs and sidewalks and pray when the beam takes the lick. After 5 hours of very tense driving, We arrive at the bridge site. There's no way we can go down the steep hill, not with this beam pushing us. We need a big bulldozer to hold us back. The truck driver sets his air brakes, but that won't stop him. This beam is coming down, and they've got to steer it to the right spot at the bottom. The driver sweats, the trailer creaks, and the brakes groan as we go as slow and easy as we can. This is not easy. Even when you do it right, the rear of the trailer is never close enough. It's got to be lifted up by a crane and scooted over to the very edge. Yeah. And after the beam has been unstrapped, the two cranes begin to lift together. The pressure's on them now. There can be no distraction as this team concentrates on the job at hand, which is 60 tons of concrete, 60 feet in the air. This is serious business. Men working together to slay the dragon. No job more important than the other. This is how you build a bridge. There were 36 of these giant beams hung at the McCall. I remember every damn one of them. How could I forget? We were making history, building the biggest bridge in Belize. And you were there too. In the episodes to come, we will follow the men of M&M Engineering and Cisco Construction as they build these two gigantic modern bridges here in Belize. You will learn much, be amazed and possibly even shocked at the jobs ahead of these men. You will most certainly feel pride in your countrymen as they work together to forge a new future for Belize. My name is Steve O'Dell, and you have been watching To Build a Bridge.